Hello everyone, welcome back on stitchingmall.com. In today's video, I will show you how to make a string neckline which is very much in fashion now, raglan sleeves that goes perfectly well with this kind of and ruffle sleeves. Fabric, we took cotton 2 meter, and measurements you need length and chest round, that's it, not much measurements needed. I took and I folded this fabric widthwise because the design pattern demands so. But if your design pattern is lengthwise, you can fold the fabric accordingly. Now we iron out the creases. And fold it in double so that we could cut front and back together. We check the fabric what we want, that will be 1/4 part of chest round plus 2 or 3 inches. If your hip is wider than chest line, then you take 1/4 part of hip plus 3 inches. Now we place it again and press and iron. There is a difference in pressing and ironing. Press we do to set the creases or the stitches or the joints. Okay, so armhole is 1/4 part of chest, that is 8 inches. You can take 1/2 inches extra, that 1/2 inch would go into seam, that would be seam allowance, but I'm taking 8 inch because I don't want much sleeve to be much loose. But depending on how loose you want your armhole to be or sleeve to be, you can take it 8 or 8.5. Then we check the back neck. Width would be 3 inch, front neck depth would be 4 inch, and back neck depth that you can keep 1 inch, 2, 3, 4 till 7 inch. But if you increase it more, then you'll have to keep overall length of the top also increased by 2 or 3 more inches. The neck, the total neck width that we'll be cutting, that would be 1/4 part of chest plus 2 inch, that is same as chest line here. Okay, so that is 1/4 part of chest plus 2 inches, so in this case it is 10 inch. Then we shape it with this 4 inch deep front neck and give it a shape. Here we have this front neck and the waist. You can cut it simply joining with the armhole. So you can straight keep the scale straight and join it till the total your bottom, your total length, whatever length you want, you can join it with that. Here we join from the sides. Then we take 2 inch inside on this neckline and join with this side marking. This is slightly slanting. We simply make a slanting line. And here we give it a small, like I make it darker, and then we'll be cutting from here. Okay, or we can give it a slight curvier shape from inside like this. So using this same design pattern or cutting pattern, you can make that sling top also. And back neck, I'm taking only 1 inch deep from the back. You can keep 3, 4, 5, 6 inch deep as you want. But then the length would be increased by 3, 4 inches more. Because when you put the string or you pull the string, the length would definitely, it will get affected. The top would be, the length would be shorter then. Okay. So we give a shape from the back sleeve also, and then we cut it from the outer side and keeping about 1/2 inch from the sides for the seams we cut. So this is the basic thing we cut, and then we keep the sleeves because now we are making raglan sleeves, and raglan sleeve making is very easy and they look very trendy, never goes out of fashion. We just simply fold the fabric and because of the pattern we cannot just keep this. Generally if the pattern allows, the design pattern allows, you can simply fold the fabric like this and draw draft and then you can cut. But here the design pattern is running on one direction, so we need to cut this fabric from the middle. Now we need to place this fabric again in the direction of our design. And now we keep our bodies of our top this way and we'll be cutting the armhole. We check the bottom of the sleeve, that we take about 6 inch or whatever you want to take, as loose or as tight you want it. Minimum 5 you would be needing, or 6 inch if you want slightly loose. You can make, you know, with this string top, if you make raglan sleeve, then you need to keep the length of the raglan sleeve at least 2-3 inches more, because when the string would be pulled, the length of the sleeve would also be slightly lesser. We keep same seam allowance as we kept on the size, that 1/2 inch or 1 inch, whatever you keep, and then we cut the sleeve and inner armhole. Now right now we are cutting only inner armhole. Okay, then we cut, this is our inner armhole, then we cut on the sleeves, that is, that will make our sleeve deeper. This is how the sleeves would be joined with front and back bodies. Now we separate, we have to cut the front neckline. So we separate both the pieces. Back neckline we have already cut, that 1 inch deep. Okay. And here we cut the front neckline. See, this is also one kind of design which you can make a dress that using pleats in the middle of this bodies, and using strings on the sides, you can make this kind of design also, or you can make it sleeveless. And this is how we'll be making it. But one more thing, I show you ruffle sleeves. See, for ruffle sleeves, because I don't want this top to be very long, so I keep, and secondly, I don't have a spare fabric of the same design pattern, so I cut the bottom about 7-8 inches that is left in the bottom of the of this dress. So I cut this thing, the length should be at least 1.5 inches more than the bottom of the sleeve, okay, and length you can keep, the width of the ruffle you can keep as you want it to be. There is no hard and fast rule that you have to keep a particular width or length. Length, of course, you need at least 1.5 inch, 1.5 times more, or 2 times, that is double. So this is bottom of our sleeve, okay, and I'll show you in the next video, I'll show you how to make the ruffles in two different methods. So this fabric, this is spare fabric, and this you can later on, you can join as ruffles, make gathers, make ruffles, and then they will be joined this way. To finish the neckline, we need 2 inch wide long bias tape. You can buy it ready made, or you can cut any contrast color or same color fabric into bias. I cut satin fabric. You can even use the same cotton fabric. Now we join sleeve with armhole of front and back bodies. It will be joined, the sleeve would be joined with the armhole same way as I shown you at the time of cutting. It is very simple. We simply keep the sleeve on the armhole starting from end of the armhole till middle of the sleeve. First we finish the front one, front sleeve, and then same way, because it is cut same, we will be stitching back of the sleeve in the same manner. Once we finish the front sleeve, it will look something like this. There is some gap in the middle. Now we use the same method to finish the another sleeve, starting from end of the armhole till middle of the sleeve. If you use pins or you use a basting stitch, then you can simply run the machine stitch around the armhole and the sleeve. There are many methods how you can achieve your goal. This is one of the method, and using pins or using a basting stitch is another method by which you can simply keep another part of the back sleeve, back armhole, and run a stitch over it. This is the back armhole. We keep it. If you want to use any kind of lace or piping, that also you can insert in middle of this joint. I have shown you in one of the earlier video how to make Dori piping. So if you want, you can make that kind of cord piping or Dori piping and insert it or use some kind of lace or beading or some contrast color, anything, piping or something. If you want to insert that, you can do that, and that will look good if the fabric is plain or if the fabric has less design. So here our sleeves are done. Now we prepare the neckline. See the back neckline, I had taken only half, about 1 inch depth. Okay, but you can keep even down. Then we'll fold and stitch front of the bias tape and stitch around the neckline, starting from back and then turning it towards the right side of the fabric. We turn one side of the strip and then make a stitch, and then keeping this in middle of the neckline, we are stitching on back side of the dress, back side of the neckline, but front of the dress. Okay, and then we stitch this bias tape around the neckline. We don't have to pull this strip much, simply hold and stitch till the middle of the front neckline. Then keeping half inch spare for folding, we lift the presser foot, cut the thread. Then we fold this end and make a stitch over it. Then we cover on this strip till middle and end of this bias tape. Here we end in middle of the neckline. Here our neckline is done, almost, not completed. This is the back side of the dress. We use a steam iron or any iron, whichever you have, and set to press the joint. The joint could be turned up or down, but only in one direction. And from each side, we'll turn it in one direction. Then we turn the dress, cut excess threads, and from middle we need to press one more time so that we could set it again. Because if the neckline is beautifully done, your dress would look nice and beautiful. So we turn it and use the press to press. Okay, in the last video yesterday I shown you what was ironing, that was to remove the creases, and here we are pressing to make the creases. Okay, to press, to hold hold this fabric in one place. So here, the same way as we pressed this strip, we'll fold it. We can use pins, or you can use even basting stitch, and then from middle of this neckline, we'll make a final stitch in the edges of this folded side. The point is, in the end, to make a string neckline or an elastic neckline, you can either put a string or ribbon or elastic that would be about a quarter of an inch wide elastic into this hole, and then your neckline would be done. If you use pins or basting stitch, the job would be easier for you, because then you won't have to hold the fabric again and again. Though it is not very difficult thing, it is easier. I use satin fabric, so it becomes a little tricky. It goes out of hand. But if you use fabric like cotton, that will be much more easier. Now we are in the middle of the front neckline, and here, if possible, get the middle of this strip in the same shape using a pin or a clip or end of the scissors or cutter. You can press it and then make a final stitch, and here our neckline would be done. See, this is done. Now one more thing before that, I tell you one more method, okay? But here we have done the sleeves, ruffle sleeve style. I'll be telling you in the next video, because I'm going to tell you two methods which you can apply. Both of them are very easy. So in the next video, if you want, you can subscribe and get the message, get the notification. So by now, we simply close the sides of this dress, starting from the sleeve till the bottom. Okay, now this is thing what I want to tell you, to make a balloon top. Raglan sleeve or this kind of a string top has enough room, it's loose enough. So in the bottom of the dress, if you want, you can simply fold. Here also you'll be needing at least 1.5 inch wide fabric in the bottom for folding. Okay, depending on how wide you want your elastic or a ribbon to be in the end of the dress, you can fold from the bottom, and here on one end you will leave about 1 inch gap here, like this. I'm keeping this gap in the side just to show you how it will be done. But you, if you want, you can keep even in the middle of the dress. And then for the final touch, we'll press the dress to set the creases and joins and seams and everything in place. So this is pressing, and then we'll use a ribbon in a clip and run around the neckline. Here, if you want an elastic, so elastic you can take about, that should be at least around, that elastic could cover your head. So your head measurement would be about 20 to 22 inches. You can check that, and based on that you can take a few inches lesser than that, and you can simply insert that elastic around this neckline, same way we insert in some kind of pajamas or something. Okay, but here we are putting a string which you can pull and make your neckline as loose or as tight as you want. And this is the simple way to make this dress. And in the bottom also, I made the hole in the side, but if you want, you can make it in the middle of the front of the dress. And then same way you can put this ribbon all around it, or an elastic. Okay, that should be at least same size as your hips. In this video, I will show you how we can make ruffle sleeves. I'll show you two methods. This is method number one. This is our sleeve bottom. This is bottom round. and we take this fabric, which is double or at least 1.5 times more than the sleeve bottom round. So here we have this fabric, and the width of this should be, it can be lesser or more, like 3, 4, 5, 6. I took about 7 inches width. You can take more or less depending on your desire. And now we make gathers on this fabric, and we'll make ruffles. For this, you can set your machine stitch regulator on the highest. So you can choose 4 or 5. On this fabric, one side you can fold and make a stitch, or other side, leaving 1/2 inch, will make a gather stitch, that is long stitch. But before that, we just fold this strip, this fabric, and make a small cut in the middle of this fabric. Then leaving 1/2 inch from the edge, we make a long straight stitch so that we could make gathers or the ruffles. Here we finish and just pick one thread, either side, you can pick from either side. Just pick one thread, there are two threads, but pick just one thread and pull so that there are gathers on our fabric. And in the middle we have a small cut, both sides we should have equal gathers. There is small cut, and same way we have to make a small cut in middle of the sleeve bottom so that we could spread the gathers equally. Now you can check that we have gathers equal and the small cut is in the middle on the fabric as well as on the sleeve bottom. Once you set your ruffles and the sleeve together, we set our machine back on a normal stitch width, stitch length. Again, you get it on 2 or 3, that is your normal stitch length, so that you don't make gathers again. We don't need to make gathers now. Now we have to just set our ruffles in place so that they don't move while we make a final stitching or joining of these ruffles with the sleeve bottom. Once we make this final stitch, then we won't have to be bothered about the movement of these gathers, because they won't move from their place. Now we have to join this ruffle with the sleeve bottom. This way it's simple, starting from one side till the end. We can make these kind of ruffles for any dress, even bottom of our dresses, or you can make double ruffle sleeves using this method. Now we make a top stitch that will make a cleaner look. It will give a cleaner look to our ruffled sleeve. For this, you have to keep the joint towards one direction and then make a top stitch, and then we'll press the sleeve. And here one method is done, you'll get your ruffles this way. Now I show you method number 2, which is a ready-made kind of a method. Same here also, we'll start the same thing. We'll take a strip or a fabric 7-8 inches width twice and double or at least 1.5 times more than the sleeve bottom. Make the gathers, pull one strand of thread, make gathers, make a small cut in the middle. Okay, till now it is same. Evenly we move the gathers, and then what happens? Now I show you the difference. Okay, this is a ready-made kind of a method. Here we check the width of our sleeve bottom round should match with the ruffles. Here they should be equal, and then we make a side closing. We'll close these ruffles. Okay, we close them. In the earlier method we didn't close it by the side, but here we have closed even the sleeve from the sides, and we turn the sleeve to the right side of the fabric or the dress. And this is back side of our ruffles out. We inserted the sleeve into these ruffles just like a skirt. So here we inserted our sleeve on the ruffles, and around the sleeve or the ruffles we make a neat normal beautiful stitch to join ruffles with the sleeve. This is a popular method, this is a better method, but to make those ruffles easier, you can adopt even the first method. That is also good, and there won't be much difference to the naked eyes. Anybody who would look at each of the method wouldn't get to know much difference. But if you have a flowy fabric or a plain fabric, use this method. If you have a printed fabric or a very flowery kind of a patterned fabric, then you can use another method. For skirt, bottom, gathers or ruffles, you can use, or the sleeve or your collar, ruffle collar, you can use method number one. And for sleeves, this is method number two, which is more popular. So just make your sleeves trendy. Even you can make your old sleeves looking fashionable using this method. Like when the sleeves are already done, already made, you can add ruffles of laces, embroidered fabrics or anything, or flowers or something, whatever you like. So this way, once you press them, your sleeves would be nicely done. They would be beautifully done. You can make a top stitch around it, keeping the joint on one direction. And do make them. Let me know how did you like this video, and keep encouraging me with your kind words. Take care. Goodbye.